Hey, race fam, Brian Davis Races, and you can too. So we're back to meal planning, and this one is going to be the easiest one yet. I figured out a little bit of a hack to making rice super simple and then creating essentially a whole meal in one cookie sheet. Meal planning has been the number one way that I lost a pretty good chunk of weight from 2018 to 2019. I used to weigh 183 pounds, and now I'm consistently down to 172, 173 pounds in the morning. So that 10-pound weight loss had a lot to do with how I was fueling my body. And essentially, I don't really care what I eat a ton. I mean, I care, but more it's about having a plan for what I'm going to eat. That seems to be the ticket for me. And all that has to do with making batches of food ahead of time so that when I am in a rush or I have to go somewhere or I don't know what I'm gonna have for lunch, like it all becomes really, really simple and you don't have to do any thinking. So today what we're gonna do is we're gonna take rice, and somebody has the greatest name for my channel ever. They call it Brian Davis Rices because all my meal planning stuff has rice involved with it so far. A little bit of salt, of course, and then I love shallots because it gives you that garlic flavor and it gives you an onion texture. I like that. And then a can of this Mexican corn stuff and then a can of beans. Today I'm going to try beans that I've been soaking for like 36 hours. And then I have a carrot just laying in there, so I'm gonna chop up the carrot in super small pieces. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna put everything in a cookie sheet. I'm gonna pour the rice in. I'm gonna pour water right on top of it. So we're gonna do two cups of rice and 4 cups of water, put some salt on it, and then just sprinkle in the other stuff. Throw that all in the oven for 25, 30 minutes. Can't really screw it up. And then when it's done, I've got a big batch of rice, veggies, beans, and I can make that into something Mexican. I can make that into something Asian. I can put it on top of a salad. I can eat it hot. I can eat it cold. It just gives me a ton of options, and it's really good, high carb, slow burning fuel that gets me through the day. And I can eat a ton of it. You can throw some avocado on there. That's a great trick to bump up the flavor profile and then give you some of those good fats as well. So that's it. Let's just do it. All right, race fam, we're going to grab 4 cups of water. You're going to throw that into the cookie sheet directly. Don't worry about much. Just try not to spill on yourself or splatter the water all over the place. So go slow. And then you're going to get 2 cups of rice. Now, some people get really worked up about rice and cooking it all perfect and whatnot. Whatever. I'm just gonna cook the rice and I'm gonna eat it in my body, and my body will never know the difference between perfect rice and rice that is cooked this way. So, whatevs. All right, and the shallots, I like to chop everything up so it's small. You know, this is only gonna be in the oven at 350 degrees for like 20, 25 minutes. So you gotta make sure everything is chopped up pretty small or else it's gonna be raw when it comes out. Speaking of raw, I screwed up by using this bean soaking method. It's a long story how I ended up with dry beans, but I tried to use them. It was a bad idea. You should definitely use a can of black beans. Don't overthink it. Just use a can of black beans. Super, super easy that way. This corn mix is really good for sweetness, and I like the texture of the corn stuff, so I love throwing that in, and then again, use the can. These beans were soaked for like 30 hours, but they still didn't. They just weren't cooked long enough, so they came out kind of crunchy. That's not ideal. And that won't happen to you if you use a can. And a generous amount of salt. I try to keep the flavoring neutral on these types of dishes because I'm going to mix it up, like I said in the intro. Sometimes I'm going to do Italian, Mexican, salad, all kinds of different stuff. Now, you can talk about my dirty oven if you want, but I'm not going to clean it. It's just dirty. But it works.
Alexa, still gets hot.
Life is good. 25 minutes later, your life just got a lot easier for the week, and you're going to eat a lot healthier. This is really all there is to it. Mix that up, all the water's gone, everything is cooked perfect, no sweat. Such an easy recipe. That's me eating it, not just cramming your face in the cupboard. So it came out pretty good. Like I said, I would use the can of beans. And then what I did after this is I actually grabbed a mole sauce. One of my students in my entrepreneurial class, maybe not everyone knows that, but in addition to the other stuff I do, I teach
very seldomly, but I do teach an entrepreneurial class, and one of the people is starting a mole sauce. She's from Mexico. The sauce is absolutely amazing, so I started making her dry powder mix for this, and it turned out amazing. So that really amps up your burrito game dramatically if you can throw some mole sauce in there. But I just threw in some footage here to remind us all why we're trying to do all this stuff in the off season and win races in the kitchen, is because when you're at this moment at the end of a race, you are regretting some of the choices that you're making. So that's all I have for you today. The goal of the channel is to grow our sport, grow our channel, The goal of the channel is to grow our sport, grow our fitness, and grow our knowledge. Hopefully I delivered that to you today. If so, please consider subscribing to the channel. We have lots of fun stuff. And I love the community that we're creating here. So thanks for watching. If you do get a chance, go visit followhollow.com and you can support me by buying some awesome socks. That'd be fantastic. And you'll be happy too. Have a good day, guys. Thanks for watching. Bye.